Well, she's a misty old day out here today. You just barely see the traffic lights over there. Oh, I think she's green. Yeller. And red. And away, away. Oh, advanced. But anyways, yeah, she's a misty day today, I guess. Even the spider webs have water droplets hanging off them. It's kind of cool, isn't it? See if I can get a nice shot in here. Water droplets. That's pretty cool. Holy crap, check this one out. That was just since last night, because I drove this thing yesterday. Of course, for a funeral, right? But, see if I can get up here without disturbing him. Yeah, I don't know where he's hiding, but could be up and around here somewhere. But it's kind of neat because it's quite a construction on these things, eh? Look at even like the support braces there on the support brace kind of thing for, you know, coming all the way down here, all up to there. Held up in here, he's probably hiding up in here somewhere. I don't know. Sorry, buddy, but I gotta wreck your web again. Took him all night to probably do that one, and I don't know if we can trick him out of here or what. If you sometimes, you know, on them things, he'll come racing out thinking there's something out on his nest or his nest on his web. Man, he sure got her supported up through here. You can't probably get the gist of her, but anyways. You gotta get to work. Anyways, how's she going, Tubes? Pretty good here. Like I see, it's misty and foggy out there. So, should hopefully clean her off soon, burn off, but anyways, I gotta dig a cremation hole, but I thought I'd show you something pretty gross. When I got on the tractor there and started it up, it was all, the steering wheel was all grimy and stuff. I'm like, oh, what the heck, you know, and I guess it's all the, you know, years of hand goo and stuff and dirt and stuff on it. But check this out, how nasty this is. Ew. And ew. Holy, it's just like brown, grimy brown stuff. That's what the towel color is supposed to be sort of like, and that's, you know, what it is now. So I just sprayed a bit of WD-40 on her and she worked good, cleaned her right off. So anyways, I guess I'll go get digging. All right, well, we better get working on our mower here. So what we're gonna do is kind of put her together kind of weird here. First way I've done her this way before. And try to put that the right way. So you're mentioning, someone mentioned about the torque on that. That's pretty well turned actually right down, so it's not really that much torque on there. So anyways, there's our new spindle. We're gonna stuff her through the mower housing here. And what else here? Try this new pulley. So everything here is new except the deck. So this should hopefully work. All right. So look at that, we got that, we got this. I just want to see if the pulley's still wobbling here. And if it is, I don't know what's going on, because if it is, I don't know what's going on, because everything here is new. Like I was saying, the only thing that's different is the deck. What in earth is going on here? Okay, gotta get her impact. Actually, one thing else I'm going to try is I'm going to grab another nut. before I crank this down here. Hang on a sec. So just to eliminate that, which I don't think there's anything wrong with the nut. I'm like 90-100% sure that there's nothing wrong with the nut, but anyways, just for argument's sakes, we'll slap her on here a new one. And crank her down. And I am baffled. I don't know what is going on here now. So this is all new stuff here. The bendagey, warpy, whatever it is, isn't as bad, but maybe that's just the pulley itself, but I think it is a way lot better than it was. Well, maybe it makes me feel a little better. So we better grab a grease gun. We're going to have to grease the crap out of that because it's a new bearing. It's going to take a lot, so let me grab the air power greaser. All right. That's interesting. I have to grab my other grease gun. I don't know what's going on. There's something wrong with the end of that now. Well, let's try this one. This is a manual hand squeezy one. It's even doing the same thing. What the heck? It's like it doesn't even really fit on. I'm like pushing really hard just to keep her from coming off, but it ends up pushing my deck over then. I think we're getting tons in her anyways. Oh yeah, I can see her coming out. That's probably good. Alright, let's slap her all back together and I guess we'll give her a shot. Alright, so I've had this dumb thing off enough here. You think by now I know how to do her, so I should be able to get her now, I'm thinking. Ugh. And that's got a hook in down here. Stay. Don't move. That's all that's holding all that spring pressure back is that cover and these two bolts. It's kind of scary. See, the design of this, I'm pretty sure they made the ramp strong enough. Because there's, you know, lots of beef in these, but it's also taking all the weight here and here, so it's actually being really hard and pushing down on the front and back there, so. I don't know if I'm super struck on their design of it. My other mower deck, you had to slide it underneath. Like this at all, so I don't know, it's a sort of a first thing, but okay, let's just see if everything's, looks like it's gonna go good there. Oh man, I'm all grimy. I'll just double make sure we got all our blades back on. Yep, looks good. Okay, let's get things in position and we shall load her on. Alright, so if you can remember the before, see I was leaving these lines and stuff up there. Now you gotta remember this is about 4 days old here now since I mowed this. So you can see the lines and stuff and like the burn marks. Okay, so that's the before. I think we might have got her, boys. Let's go have a look here. And there's an after. You can sort of see the odd little burn and stuff, but that's probably mostly because of the ground. But Most of the rows I've been doing here are actually pretty good now, so you don't see like those definite lines left in it, right? Where it's been kind of burning it off weird or whatever. So I'm presuming we got her fixed here. it looks a lot, and actually these things here are probably tire marks. They're not so much like cut in, burn off marks, right? So, yeah, I'd say, yeah, looking at it with my eyes here, I can see where I drove, and that's tire mark. So, that's good. I think we got her solved. Alrighty, well, we put on about an hour and a half, roughly, mowing, and she all seemed good, so that makes me happy. It was sort of leaving a little bit of a line still, but I think it might have been maybe the blade. It wasn't sort of the sharpest blade when I put her back on, so that was on this side, but before we did all this, we'll say it was 100% bad, okay? Now, if I would say between 0 and 100% bad, I'd probably say maybe 10% bad kind of thing. So it has improved like 90% kind of thing, you know, but there's still a little bit of a line I can see there getting dragged. So I just think it's the blade itself, but I didn't hear the, you know, as I'm mowing, like it's getting clogged up, that kind of noise. As I was mowing, I didn't hear that, so I'm guessing that's a good thing. So that made me happy. should be a little more better, but time will tell again, of course. And yeah, you can see some of those little spots I was showing you there with the thumbs down. I have no idea why people think they gotta leave crap like that laying there. Freaking light. Crap like that laying there for no apparent reason other than for me to get nailed with the mower, because 9 times out of 10 I won't see that. It's sometimes gets covered in a bit of grass, you know, and I'm kind of looking at the stone right here. I'm not really looking too much at what's coming like right here. I'm making sure I'm not rubbing the stone, so by the time that thing gets here, it's already under the deck and I'm screwed. And I've like sucked her up or fired her at the side, and you know, if something like that gets a bit of speed on her, it's gonna go and hit like the other monument that's in the next row beside it. It's like, wow, really? It's really stupid to leave stuff like that. Many times people will put those little porcelain-y angels kind of down in the grass there. I hit that, it just blows that to dust. But a rock's a little bit harder than that, right? And man, that's probably what did the bearing in on this one and bent that shaft and then broke the housing on the other one, because I know I hit a few good rocks there. People leave them down, I can't see them, and then boom, then you get fired in there. Holy crap, there was one I hit. I might even take a drive back and show you like what happened. But I nailed that bloody rock so incredibly hard, which probably did it there. It's hard to say because I've hit quite a few of them, you know, without being able to see them. It nailed that thing, and so I'm mowing along, and it was like in line, like, well, I'm watching here, right? So hang on a sec. I'm watching here for the monuments to go by, but this thing was like in about here, so it got sucked in, accelerated, I guess, with that one, accelerated with the middle one, hit the last one. This thing just went like this. I'm catching this out of the corner of my eye, and by the time I looked and up to see where it went, it had already gone and hit a big tree that's in the middle of the big section back there and was on its way back again. So I don't know what speed that thing was going or what size even was, but oh my goodness, that thing had freaking speed on it like you wouldn't believe, you know. So I guess this blade got her going, that one helped her, that one got her going full speed, whatever the blade probably was turning at that speed, so it's going out at 200 mile an hour. Hit that tree, and like I say, by the time I looked up to see, because I seen this thing go like this, you know, flopping around like that from the thing coming out and hitting it, it had already hit a tree, like I say, and was bounced off of the tree and was already coming back towards me. And it was like a long way off too, like it was probably from here to the bridge away, you know, and I'm mowing down here, say, hit it, by the time I look, it's already like halfway back, and like, bing, 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 and I went and picked it up, and I don't know what I did there then, but I'm like, really, people, Stop putting stones and rocks out at your graves. They don't need to be there. I have cleaned up so many graves too with people that think, and I swear they come. If I had a funeral or something and the weather was inclement, like winter time, I don't put the topsoil on it till spring because there's no point in doing that. I swear they come and they take some rocks off the top of someone's grave and take them over and put them on theirs. For some weird unknown reason, I have no idea what the idea is behind it. But for instance, let's go over and have a look at this. So I've been bringing up some gravelly and stuff here, nice cleaner gravelly stuff to fill in this sort of bit of a pit hole here, right? Make her up a little bit nicer. And so we'll say, you know, this is the kind of dirt I'm bringing out. So we'll say this is someone's grave, okay? So this has all been filled in, someone's buried here, blah, blah, blah. Not really someone's buried here, this is just dirt here. But for instance, this is kind of what it would look like until I can get in with the topsoil. Well, they'll come and take like these kind of rocks, you know, and like put them like around their thing and stuff, you know, around the grave and stuff, and then some grass starts to grow up over it. I can't see that. If I hit that thing with my mower, look at that, it'll probably break something. That's a pretty big rock, you know, that some knob has just grabbed and put there because they like the rock. Oh yeah, look at this one actually. It's got a hole in it. Cavity rock. But anyways, I mean, really, like, what the heck? Why would they have to do this? I really, really don't understand, and if I ever catch anybody doing it, man, they'll be eating those rocks, I'll tell you that one. You know, not that I don't mind fixing my mower, but really, if I don't have to, I don't need to, right? Like, and then just the headache of trying to figure out what the frick's wrong with it, why is it cutting like that, and having to fix it, you know? Which I really don't mind, like I say, fixing it, but, because, you know, I know how to do it and stuff, but, holy man, if I didn't know how to do it, this thing would probably be in John Deere for like a week. Time I get it back, I'd have grass up to my earballs, and that would just really suck. So, but I don't know. People and the things they do, even in here, it's like, what in the frick are you thinking? You know, it just makes no sense at all. So, anyways, that is that. But anywho, I really wish I could show you this next part here I gotta do today, but I really can't, because I'd probably get fired. But anyways, I got a urn, cremation urn thing in the other day. It's one of them urn vault things. I can show you the side of them, I guess, here. That's it there. And then the, you know, shiny spots, got the name on stuff on it. And it's pretty big. It's 19 by 19 by like 22 deep. So it's pretty big. But that come up from a cemetery down in the city. I guess they want to move up here. So I'm like, yeah, okay, fine, whatever. So I got to go dig a hole. And I got the rope around it there because there's nowhere to grab it, right? So I basically wrapped the rope around it. There's little indents in the side. I can show you that. Hang on. There's like these little indents in the side, right? And so what I did is I roped her and then ran on the top. So when I grab it, I can pick it up and then just roam down in a hole. So I gotta go dig that, do that this afternoon, but this is actually concrete. Pretty hard. Hard stuff. Heavy too. And, well, you can see it's kind of got chipped a bit there when they dug them out. So, but, yeah, that's for urns. Cremation urns. So, I guess she looked nice when she was new, but she's all dirty and scummy now, but it's gonna be worse when I'm done. They're gonna get dirty and scummy again. So, anyways, that's what I gotta do this afternoon. And, yeah, I wish I could show you that, but, there's no family gonna be here, but, I was told not to do that stuff, so anywho, that's the way that works. Anyway, showing you that and then not showing you the name and stuff, that's fine, but doing the actual digging and burial, I can't do that, so I apologize, but that's the way she is. If it was my cemetery, I'd have no problems, but it's not me saying that, it's my superiors, we'll say, are saying that, so they're just trying to not, you know, get in trouble with, you know, a family had seen that or something, they might not have liked that, but nobody's gonna know who that is or, you know, dates or anything like that. So, if I showed a name, that'd be different. That'd be bad. But, yeah, so, anyways, I gotta do that this afternoon. Should be good. Well, not for him, but for me. Give me a bit of exercise. It's gonna have to be a fairly big, deep hole. But where he's going, actually, this is pretty much right beside one down from the one I did this morning, which was actually really nice digging. It was nice. Why am I all of a sudden just rolling away here? Hmm. Well, that's interesting how it sat there that whole entire time. And now we're heading south. I guess I better maybe stop this. Craziness. I don't know. Don't ask me. That's the way she works. But anyways, so I've got something special-ish coming up. Exactly when, I don't know. We're just in preparation of getting it going now. And it does involve some kind of remote control vehicle. So that'll sort of spoil her a bit there for you, but there, I don't have to hold the brakes now. Something we haven't done for quite a while, which I figured, oh, maybe I better do her again, you know, and see if we can get her going and stuff. So, but anyways, that's enough of that for now, because I don't know exactly when I'm going to do it yet. Probably won't be this week. No, it won't be probably this week. I might try it tomorrow and then maybe have it posted for you for Sunday, because Iron Man and I are going on a road trip on Sunday. So, yeah, but anyways, look at this. I got to show you one other thing here, too. It's so depressing. Look at the top of this tree already. It's always the first part to go. I should go up there and cut that piece out of there so it's not so depressing so early in the fall time-ish. But the rest of the tree is nice and green still, but that's always the first bit to start saying, yep, g'day, we're gonna start turning colors. And that's the start of her, boys. That's the start of her. She'll be nice and fiery red and orange and yellows in here for a little while, and then they'll be all on the ground, and then I gotta start doing all that again, chopping them up, put the kit back on the old mower here, and start mulching again. Mulching's not too bad. Mulching's better than bagging them up and having to dump out the bags all the time. That really sucks. But anywho, that's the way she works. Well, I know you are all dying, but I'll give you a couple little hints. It involves this. Well, not the end bit. It's my charger cable. It involves this. That actually took 302 milliamp to charge again, so that's not too bad. Might involve some of this, if it's any good. I don't know. It's probably mostly going to involve this, if it'll go. It's been like 2 years or something. I don't know. Seems a little hard to pull over, so it might be a little corroded in there. She might start and run for a bit, but it might not run for too long. I don't know. Whoa, my glide, well, that's over. Holy cow, I had pretty well...
a squeaky door.
Pretty well a whole loader bucket of dirt dug out of this hole for this guy, for his box that I just showed you, just to get him in there and have like 2.5 foot of coverage over him. And this is the dirt I got left over. So this whole side was right full. That's what we used to fill back in. And this was the remainder out of the hole. So it was pretty darn near a whole entire loader bucket. I'll tell you, you don't appreciate how much your loader bucket holds per scoop until you shovel one by hand. Pretty much, well, I cut her with the square mouth and got her nice and square, and then pretty much dig down as far as I can with this until it kind of doesn't work so much anymore. And then I turn to this feller here, and he's just you see me fix it a couple weeks ago there, and then scoop and pull out and dump. Works good. It's heavy though. I think it probably weighs about 30 pounds. This bar is probably about 30 pounds, 40 pounds maybe. It's heavy too. That used to be a drive shaft way back. You can see the splines on her. But she's a good chipping bar now. So, ooh, that's a lot of digging. It was good digging though. It was all this stuff, hardly any gravel until I got right to the very bottom. Like, sweet. But the lowering with the rope worked good. Just picked him up, down he went. Worked excellent. So, yes, that worked really good, but got a little bit of surplus dirt, so that's good. And I saved the sod off the grave and then put it back in and then tamped it down, so should be all good there. So, yeah, that was exerciseable, we'll say. It's good for the upper body anyways. I wish... kind of wishing I had one of those augers, but it wouldn't have been big enough for this. It only drills a 12-inch hole, where this had to be, I did it like 22 by 22 by 3 feet deep. So she wouldn't have drilled a big enough hole, and kind of fitting a square box into a round hole wouldn't have worked probably so well. So, oh man, there's another tree over there starting to change too. Can you believe her? She's going, boys, she's going. Oh, pretty soon there'll be no green left. Who knows? It all depends on the weather, right? If they get a bunch of weather that's really cold and stuff at night, it tricks them trees to thinking, oh, winter's coming, you better start changing the leaves. And that's basically the green chlorophyll coming out of the leaves. And the chlorophyll is the stuff that feeds the tree. Now, I presume that chlorophyll goes back into the tree. I don't know if it just dissipates out and then the leaves just turn. They're basically dried out, you know, and then they turn whatever color they turn. So, I know it's the chlorophyll that feeds the tree through the year. Still don't know how they do it. You know, they're only out for, well, June, July, this is August. It's only 3 months out of, like, the rest of them. Somehow they still survive. Well, I don't know. It's pretty amazing, I'll tell you. But I guess it stores it all in the root system or something. And then maybe it sort of goes into a dormant phase, I guess, for the winter, where it's not really doing anything. And then as soon as the warm hits again, like your sap and stuff, it starts sucking it all up and then feeding the tree again, right? So that brings her back to life, I guess. So I guess if you have an issue with a root system, that'll kill your whole tree, like right there. Could not be nothing wrong with the tree part itself. Above ground, it could be all the root system that's screwed up, right? So I'm not a tree, whatever you call them, by far, but you know, I know a little bit to get by, and that's you know, done me well. So, but anywho, guess that's about it for today. Filter's ready for the car, but the car's not here right now, so won't do that. But anyways, I do apologize. I don't know when this is going to actually get uploaded. YouTube has been uploading my Farm Sim Saturday for, well, a day and a half now, almost. And it's taken forever. I don't know why. Thought it was my connection. I redid all my stuff. Tests okay on the online testers, but YouTube's doing it again. It must be a Friday. But anyways, that's the way that works, I guess, too. So, but I'm going to head her home. That's the end of today. I had a couple of super nice visitors come and see me, so thanks for the visits today. And the one visitor that came and brought me the stuff, thank you very much for that. You know what it is, and nobody else does. I'm not telling anybody. No, I'm not telling you what it is. It's a big secret, and I can't tell you. So don't try to force it out of me, because I'm not telling you, because it's a big secret. But anyways, yeah, so thanks for the visit, though. That was awesome. Wish I wasn't so super slammed right now. We could have visited longer, but... And he also rides a bike. Didn't have the bike today, but one day we'll hook up, I'm sure. Maybe we'll drag Iron Man, too. We were talking about that, so... Drag old Iron Man down there, and we'll have some laughs and giggles and stuff, I'm sure, and have a good time. But anyways, Farm Sim Saturday hopefully is going to be up in time. I don't know. I haven't been up to check it all afternoon, so maybe it's done now uploading. I don't know, but it's been like yesterday at like 9:30 or something I started it, and it's been sitting there and sitting there and sitting there and going and going. Last I checked, it was like 40% done, so I've still got a lot more to go, another 60, you know, so bloody YouTube. I don't know why they have to do this to us. I don't know if they're upgrading servers again, or it seems like every Friday, or usually every Friday, they're screwing up stuff. Messing with stuff, so I don't know, whatever. But I'm gonna head her home. You guys have a good night. Thanks for watching this week and today and stuff, and we'll catch ya. You know, I was supposed to see that. We'll catch ya. Oh man, I'm gonna have to do something about that. Should flip that bucket up on its end, maybe. Also gotta do something with this guy too. I gotta redo the top dewy on this, I think. Make her a little bit more like I did on that one there, on that bucket. It'd be a lot stronger. It actually did flip off on me one day, so that flips me off a bit. Didn't like that. But anyways, we're going to head her out. We will catch you guys next week. If not, possibly Iron Man are doing that. Iron Man and I are doing something on Sunday, and I'm not telling you what yet, because I don't really know what we're doing yet. Honestly, I have no real idea. I know we're going on a road trip. But what's going to be going on, I don't know. We will see when we get there. But anyways, yep, thanks for watching today. We'll catch you next week, and have a good weekend. And, yeah, I'll see you then.